The title of our presentation is Geoarchaeological Record of Burrows, Structure of Komarov Culture from Bronze Age and Post-Deposition Processes Occurring in the Imbukivna in West Ukraine. I prepared this presentation with my colleagues, Professor Przemysław Makarowicz and Professor Zhanna Nikolaevna Matvishina from Ukraine. Our presentation shows the period of development of Komarov culture on the area of Ukraine. Komarov culture was formed on an aerial cord-shaped culture in the areas of Podolia, Subcarpathians, and southern part of Wołynia in the Middle Bronze Age, between 1800 to 1400 centuries BC. One of the largest concentration of Bronze Age Komarov culture is Burial Mound and at Bukivna, where in a radius of 5 kilometers have been documented 150 burrows. This culture is known above all of funeral rites, especially for many mounds. The main equipment of burrows is flint tools and pottery. Characteristic bronze artifacts were found in the burrows, bodkin and pendants. They are subject of spectral analysis to indicate the content of tin and the main component of bronze. Radiocarbon dating of organic residues in mounds of burrows and soil under burrows indicate the period of development of studies area of Komarov culture. This radiocarbon dating. The study area is located on the right side of Dniester River in the region of South Podolian Upland in Ivano-Frankivsk Oblast on the west Ukraine. A significant part of Podolian Upland is covered with thick loose cover. The region rises from 200 to 700 meters above sea level. The investigated area is strongly affected by dissection caused by river erosion. A characteristic landform is an elongated plateau that separates broad valleys and basins. Actually, dominant soil cover at the areas where burial mounds occur is podzolized soil. In modern times, the surface of burrows is covered by the forest. A detailed geomorphological map present the location of mounds on the Opilia Plateau, which belongs to the Podolian Upland, on the top parts of the plateau. This is located of burrows on the plateau. The main aim of study was the answer of following questions. Are the environmental conditions at the time where mounds were built and contemporary conditions similar or different? Is the material from which the mounds were built shows lithological compatibility with the ground? Does geochemical composition of mounds correspond to geochemical background? And which level of enrichment of in geochemical components are dominated or, and can be distinguished in burrows? How post-depositional processes could change the lithological and geochemical composition of sediment in burrows? Are the fillings pottery vessels found in burrows differ lithologically and geochemically? Stratigraphy of the burrows number 2 in Bukivna shows from the floor black color organic soil from the Bronze Age on the last ground, burial mound with different soil horizon in the top of the profile, and thin organic layer, the humus level of the modern soil. Methods of sedimentological, paleopedological and geochemical study. From sediment samples taken into Kubiena's boxes, thin section micromorphology analysis and also paleosoil analysis was carried. From the mound profile, samples were taken from granulometric and geochemical analysis. Attempts were also made to fill of depotary vessels from the examined mounds from the same research. Charcoal and another organic material was radiocarbon dated. Main chronological pollen zones. In the transformation of vegetation on the local scale is shown by palynological diagram based on core of peat deposits from the old riverbed near village Łuka in the western part of Halicz-Pukaczewski Basin in the Dniester Valley. In palynological studies conducted on Ukraine, the problem of poor pollen preservation status is known. Pollen is corroded and usually a few. In the studies, it was also similar. At the Atlantic and sub-Atlantic zone, we could observe the decline of in forest. In sub-Atlantic periods, there's an expansion of the alder, and they are cereals, cerealia and phagopyrum, and another species of herbs has been found. Next. The profile of modern soils has been tested on a trench outside of the burial mound. The modern soil of the burial mound develops under conditions of intense hydrizon, signs of glaying processes. It had clearly distinguished alluvial and eluvial horizons, a short profile with light gray humus from the top shows signs of development of washing processes. In the bottom part, the soils, the mobility of aluminium, iron, and manganese is recorded. The nature of this profile and micromorphological indices allow the soil to include it in the type of gray podzolized soils of the forest zone. The infiltrates with the profile are different. In the upper part, they show signs of context of silt humic substance, dark gray, open. In the horizontal plane, in bottom part, they are transparent ferruginous. Colomorphic aluminium infiltrators occur simultaneously with the precipitation of iron oxides in the form of hard pan and manganese stains. The mechanical composition in the alluvial level is fine clay, and in the eluvial medium to coarse. The soil reflect in the conditions for the formation of coniferous deciduous forests with moderately humid climate. Soil horizon under the burrow is centrally a chernozem with mainly processes of accumulation of organic matter which shaped the level of humus with the high thickness. Even accumulation of organic matter which shape of even at the depth the depth of 60 centimeters from the soil's surface, there is still organic matter. The humus profile of the of this thickness could be arisen in warmer conditions than today under a rich, most probably different size grassy vegetation in the conditions of northern steppe or forest steppe. In the wall humus layer, crotovinas are visible, indicating of activity of soil fauna. Evidences of profile, leaching and infiltrations, some degree of dispersion of organic matter and its penetration to a bigger depth are associated with sufficient and possibly excessive moisture. In the conditions of warm temperate climate, there are signs of glaying processes in the wall profile some aluminium on iron accumulation related to the partial displacement within the profile. The grain size distribution of samples taken from the barrels profiles and from the vessels fillings indicate that predominant fraction is in the sediment, is the silt fraction, the content of which is up to 50% of sediment. 25% of sediment and more may be clay. The sand fraction is characteristic for the surface samples in the profile and some vessels fillings. In the vertical profile of mounds, we can observe slightly bigger fractions of the mechanical composition in the surface layers of burial mounds. The biggest content of organic matter is present in the level of fossil soil, and the accumulation of calcium carbonate is in the alluvial level of the modern soil. Geochemical analysis indicate enrichment in copper, zinc, and iron in the soil level from the Bronze Age, and additionally phosphorus in the large part of burial mounds. In the vessels fillings, in many cases, an increase and the micro elements content exceeding the geochemical background was not. Similarly, in the vicinity of vessels and an object. And conclusion, modern soil covering burial mounds is similar to the podzolized forest soil with humus alluvial levels and alluvial and ferruginous layers. Paleozoil, similar to the podzolized leached Chernozems, is distinguished by the dark gray color of horizon and predominance of the humus accumulation. Its features are deep variation, gradual transition between levels, more light mechanical composition with increasing depth. In many to nature character of soil forming processes is confirmed by numerous protovenas, activity of soil farm. Fossil soils were created in conditions more humid than steppe ones, probably in conditions of forest steppe in non-forest areas, where a lot of grass grew and organic matter was actively accumulated. In the soils, the characteristic of leaching were observed. The admixture of silica is more abundant in the typical humus and dispersing of humus. These soils develop under meadow vegetation in conditions of moderately warm climate with enough rainfall. In the mounds, the silt fraction dominates, which admixtures of clays and very fine-grained sands. The mineral composition of barrows was also influenced by post-depositional processes, podzolization, and the process of contributing to leaching clay components from the alluvial layer to washing them into the alluvial layer. Geochemical analysis indicate the diversity of content of micro and macro elements in barrows sediment. Geochemical enrichment show object places of burial vessels filling, which may also be absent. The highest phosphorus content was recorded in them. Some probably weapons or other accessories made of bronze were put into the graves with that. This is indicated by the contents of trace metals such as tin, zinc, and copper. A very frequent element of funeral rites of the Komarov culture was the insertion of ochre into the grave. It could be put in the vessels or fillet filled with the entire burial chamber. In the burial mound number one, at the depth of over 2 meters, iron contents was over 70,000 milligrams per kilogram. Lack of preserved bands, except burned out, wood and other organic residues indicates the mineralization of organic components. Thank you for attention.